of the Australian music industry has uncovered some shocking figures of sexual harm, harassment and discrimination. The Raising Their Voices report was released this morning.
Yeah, the review has found that 55% of people in the music industry have experienced some form of workplace sexual harassment and sexual harm in their career. And one musician who helped get this review underway is Deena Lynch, aka Jaguar Jonze, who joins us now from Brisbane. Deena, so great to have you with us this morning. This is a huge day for you personally. The culmination of 2 years of advocacy, which began when you were allegedly assaulted by two music producers. It led to more people telling their story and ultimately this review. What have you and survivors had to sacrifice to get to this point?
Oh, it's been a lot of sacrifice and energy from survivors to get it to this point. You know, aside from putting your careers and reputations on the line and then having to deal with the consequences from speaking up, you're also reliving your trauma every single day and taking on the burden of pushing and hard work and energy that the industry leaders should have been doing to get this review to the place that it is now and to try and, you know, create some cultural change.
So who did the review and what were some of the key findings?
So the review was conducted independently by Map and Consulting, led by Alex Shahadi and Sam Turner and their team. And the findings have been distressing to look at. It's unacceptable levels of sexual harm, sexual harassment and systemic discrimination. Women do not thrive to the same extent as men. And young people, as well as people from diverse backgrounds, are more at risk to harm and poor employment practices.
Deena, we're just looking at some of the images from your artwork. Your music videos and the music that you have produced has put into words everything that you've experienced and the message that you're sort of taking to the world. The report also looked into bullying. 76% said they had been bullied, yet only 6% reported it. You look at all the sexual harassment figures of 72% of women, but only 3% reported sexual harassment. What were some of the stories that artists have told you in the survey or told the interviewers in the survey?
Well, I've been hearing stories from artists and survivors for so long. This movement came about when I posted a social media post and I was expecting, you know, a handful of people to respond to me, but I got 400 in my inboxes. So I wasn't shocked to find the findings from the report today because I've been aware of it for so long. I just really hope that it's a moment for people to really not run away from what is very apparent a cultural problem in our industry, and that change can come from this.
What changes do you want to see happen in the industry?
I really want to make sure that we're moving on from putting the responsibility on the grassroots and those with less privilege, less power and a smaller platform to take on this work. I really hope this is a wake-up call for our industry leaders to use their resources and implement the 17 recommendations that came from the report today.
Deena, your debut album, Bunny Mode, is all power. I've seriously been listening to this. I know all of these songs, they are just incredible. You've taken your career into your own hands and you are on the way to global stardom. So now that this report has been released and the advocacy that you've had to do over the last couple of years, do you hope that, you know, you can kind of take a step back and let the industry now do the work that needs to be done to free you up to make the music that you want to make?
Yes, definitely. I've been putting the advocacy before my artistry for so long, but the truth is I came into this industry to be an artist, and that's what I'd like my next steps to be. I have so much to offer beside my advocacy work, and I really want to show Australia all of my artistry, and I'm excited to create some new work.
Can't wait to see it. We're here for it. Jaguar Jonze, thank you. And if this discussion has raised any issues with you, then 1-800-RESPECT is available 24/7.